Yo, what is up, guys? Jason from Jason Thomas, and today we're back with another video. And today's video is on the Hornby 52XX. Now, I just recently got this locomotive, and I think it's nice. I think it's good looking and powerful. And this is my first Great Western based engine in the BR colors. Not all my engines are BRs, they're all BR colored. Or not all of them, they're close to BR color, but they're not actual BR based engines. Like, take my LNR wide tank. It is a Furness Railway engine painted in the British Railway colors, along with my E4 being an LSBSC engine, or the Southern Railway engine, it's just painted in BR. But today we're reviewing the 52XX, and I say let's just hop into the history of it. So the 52XXs, or the Great Western Large Classes, they had 42s and 52s were the same, or 72s, which I'll put in the top left corner, were the same things, just 282s. So they had a little extra two wheels at the back and larger bunker. And these engines were, they came in 1906 by George Jackson, Churchwell, and Chief Mechanical Engineer of the Great Western Railway between 1902 and 1922. And they were 280s of the 42s and the 52s. So they were basically technically the same, just two different types. They had some minor differences, but they were hardly noticeable. But as on the history, let's hop into the detail. Alright guys, we're back. And before we hop into it, this is the original box that it came in. And same details, but it came from Hornby, and I will can I zoom out. It has the brief history of it, seeing it's in 8F. So we'll pause that and let you guys can pause it and read about it if you guys want to. And then we have a little picture diagram of it. But let's just hop straight into detail on the 52XX. And if I can open the box, it's hard to open. You also get a pack of little details and extra couplers. These that go on the bottom. So it basically go on the bottom down here. But I'm gonna put these back in the box and I can start the review. If I can get everything back into the box. Alright. Zoom in. It's nice. We'll start from the back and work our way to the front. Now, it's not bad at the back. Has your little hooks where you can put the head coat disc or lamps. And then we have the number 5231. And if you guys look really closely, it has the letter E. We also have good coal detail. If you look closely, you'll see the detail in the cab. The regulator is painted red with all the valves and piping. And then I set on the track for right now. Lower it. You have the BR Railway crest, the early crest with rivets. Cylinders are very nice. And under it, you also have the little valves pumped under it. And then we have under it, we have 8 drive wheel pickups. So all the wheels have pickups. And it looks like it would run nice with a 3 or 5 pole motor. And then them coupling in the back. Now, sadly, this engine doesn't have sprung buffers. It's not, I think it has a die cast running board. It's heavy on the bottom, but light on the top. Something in this thing could pull a lot of cars or coaches. It's not bad. We move on to the front, to the smoke box door. You see, we can do it that way. If you look closely, ...86.8 is on the front. 5231 on the smoke box door with all the handrails, piping. But yeah, it's a very nice detailed engine. I like the little whistle. I think it is made out of plastic or metal, but it's still nice. But after looking at it closely, let's get into the running review of it. Alright guys, we're going to move into the slow speed proportions. Now we're going to start going backwards and let's see how slow it can go. I'm twisting it as slow as I can go. Oh, I think I got stuck. I'm thinking that's the slowest it's going to go before it gets stuck. And then we'll move it forward. So it's not bad moving slowly. It's not bad. If I had to rate this engine, I'd give it a 9 out of 10. An 8 out of 10. It could use a little bit more detail. I think we could have colored more of the, or made a more detail on the top. Maybe on the whistles and a little bit more detail under it. But otherwise, this engine is good. I like it. The price I paid for it in pounds was, Rails of Sheffield were having a sale. So £89.50, which was around $100. $100 out here. So hope you guys enjoyed. I will leave a link for one of these in the description if it's there. Make sure to share this video, like, subscribe, and make sure to watch the latest video to the left, subscribe to the right. That's about it, guys. Peace out.